Sam Labruna joining Australian Boxing Central, the man credited with the plan that brought down Jeff Horn first time around. Great to have you with us today, mate.
Yeah, mate, thank you, buddy. I appreciate you coming around.
And just tell us a little bit about Sam, about Michael's preparation so far as we near the end of camp. Obviously, the fight upcoming next week. How's preparations been up to this date?
Yeah, no, he's very confident, as you can imagine, after the first win. So he's all on track. We're all happy as a team, and I couldn't have him any better.
And first time around, obviously got, the sensational victory.
Yes.
Tell me how satisfying it was first time around getting that victory, especially considering you guys felt that, the Horn camp underestimated Michael and Team Labruna as well.
Look, we were waiting for this fight, and, I just couldn't believe that we actually got it in the end. So we're very confident, as, people know. And we're even more confident going in for the second time. So, I can't wait for it to happen. And, I'm just excited.
I think you stated first time around, before the first fight, that, they were making a big mistake in selecting Michael as an opponent. Second time around, do you feel the same way? It's a big mistake on their end?
100%. We all know the way I am as a trainer and as a person. And, for me, the fighter's health comes first. And I think they've overlooked that. Jeff's not a middleweight. Number one. Number two is it was a convincing victory the first time.
Yep.
I think I'd give Jeff one round, to be honest. He got dropped twice and, he got hurt. And just putting him back again, I just thought, that the management, the trainer, would have thought about it properly and, maybe gone a different route. The Zerafa fight would have been there if he could have proved himself that, that he could go at middleweight. So to me, it's just a big mistake. And we've been getting told, just get on with the job. And that's what we've been getting told. And you know what? We're getting on with the job. So we're ready. Michael's ready. And I can't wait. I'm super excited for this fight. I wasn't so much at the start, but I am now.
Yeah, I think with the looming opportunity overseas against Murata was obviously something that you guys were super keen on. But, the rematch was forced.
Yes.
I know in the first fight, Glenn Rushton was heavily criticised for not stopping the fight earlier than what he did.
Yep.
Your take on, that situation, do you feel as though it was left way too long?
Oh, 100%. I mean, if you watch the fight, I was actually standing on the apron of the ring. To me, the fight was over. And I couldn't believe it. I was told to sit down and we're going to go again. And so I couldn't believe what I was watching. So, it was just a huge mistake on their behalf. The towel should have been thrown in. I mean, there's nothing worse. Me especially, from where I come from and what I know and what I learn, than a tough trainer.
Yeah.
That's how I look at it. Like, they want to make this, Rocky story, but it's the kid that's in the gym, in the ring and in the gym, it's not you. So, I reckon he deservedly, he needed to be criticised and, it shouldn't happen again. I'm hoping this time round that they've got a better game plan. And if something like along them lines happens again, hopefully they act, the proper way this time around. So,
well, I guess with that in mind, obviously you feel as though Michael's going to, win convincingly second time around. What is it that you think separates Michael from Jeff Horn as a fighter? What is it that Michael has over him?
Yeah, okay. So first of all, it's just size. Weight, size, reach, speed. Just in general boxing, he's got it over Jeff. But I think what it is as well, we've gone away as a team, we've watched the tape several times, we've picked up on what Jeff's good at, we've picked up on what he's not good at, even more now, and we've worked hard to fix up our little mistakes that we've made, and we've been doing them in sparring, so I'm predicting 3, 4 or 7 round, it'll be over. Now, depending on the aggression of Jeff, we'll gauge it, but 3, 4 or 7, I think the fight will be over.
And what did you make of first time round? Obviously, the Horn camp came in super confident. They thought they were going to get the victory. And then after the fight, obviously, there was, rumours about a training camp that wasn't that great. Diet wasn't fantastic, all that sort of thing. How did that sort of make you feel after the fight? Because I know, sort of speaking to you off camera, you guys felt like it was a bit of a cop-out.
Yeah, definitely. Look, unprofessional. Very unprofessional by Glenn Rushton and his team. Coming out and saying all these things. They said they knocked out Mundine and he's hitting like a heavyweight and, this preparation is next to none and, he's his weight division because he's big and he doesn't need to cut weight and, all this nonsense and very arrogant. Four rounds, They told us that they could beat Cal Brook in 4 rounds and stop Cal Brook. That's what their comments. So it's like ludicrous, you know? It's just ludicrous. I mean, Glenn Rushton's got a lot to learn about boxing, so that's how I feel about him. I certainly have no respect for the guy. When it comes to boxing, I have no respect for Glenn Rushton whatsoever. You know, he's shown me, you know, what I've seen with Jeff in the ring, I've got doubts, you know, for these fighters, for their health. And you know what, Jeff Fenwick said the same thing, I'm saying the same thing. I mean, you know, it won't be too long before people start seeing it, you know. You need defence in boxing. If you can't teach defence, right, you know, don't throw kids in the ring, you know, you get in there. That's how I see it.
I guess, Sam, you're one on social media, a bit of an antagonist, I think it's fair to say.
And I love riffing everybody up, that's right. And, you know, I don't give it back and whatever. And, you know, it's boxing at the end of the day. We love the sport.
Mate, I think it's great. I think it adds a bit of character to the sport, why not? But yeah. I did see a few weeks back that you made a post to say that if Jeff was to lose to Michael again, that you would offer to train him yourself and to teach him defence and
100%.
And the things that you feel like he might be lacking.
Yep.
If he was to lose, does that offer still stand?
100%. I mean, Jeff's welcome to come to the gym. He can spend a week down in Melbourne. We'll go over what we do here and what we learn. It'll be a real eye-opener for the kid.
And I guess any final words for the Horn camp leading up to next week? Is there anything that you want to say to Glenn or Jeff?
Look, I just want, at the end of the day, the talking's done. I just want, you know, a safe fight. At the end of the day, you know, I'm very confident we're going to win, but as long as the both fighters walk away safe and we get the victory, it's happy days.
Sam, we'll see you in Brisbane next week. All the very best.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.